We stand for the fruit of the flesh. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic, which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Again for K3B Live, The Quest.
So, you know, we got a great show today.
Yeah, we do. You having a little trouble with your bandana?
Yeah.
Not ready to represent Echo?
Nah.
Not what I like to see, Greg. Not what I like to see.
All right.
Let's get into the news.
Today's K3B holiday is International Goof-Off Day. According to HolidayInsights.com, they suspect that this holiday was created by hardworking families. They also reported that video games were the most popular activity moving on. News.yahoo.com said that this day is for some people who forget all responsibility and have fun, assuming you won't get in trouble in school because many people work too hard and need a day to relax.
Every year, just like the NFL, the NHL has their own annual draft.
So, thanks, Christina. I'm here live with, for the 8th grade, we have Ty Schaefer.
Hi.
Brennan McGar for the 7th grade.
Hi.
And Danny Burns for the 6th grade.
What's up?
This is a K3B challenge. We all have to do our own quiz. So let's get the show on the road. So where is the NHL 2013 draft going to be? Is it going to be A, Staples Center? Maybe B, Prudential Center? Could it be C, Madison Square Garden? Or is it D, Continental Energy Center? So guys, write down your answers. Yeah, so here's a little hint. This arena was built in October of 2007. Okay, so, Ty, what did you get?
B.
Brennan, what did you get?
B.
And Dan, what did you get?
B.
Well, the correct answer is B, Prudential Center. So, congratulations, guys. You all win Sour Patch Watermelon. Congratulations. Congratulations, Danny.
Thank you.
Back to you guys in the studio.
The Prudential Center reported that the Prudential Center's main attraction is at the home of the New Jersey Devils. PrudentialCenter.com also stated that the arena can seat 17,625 fans for hockey games and 18,711 for basketball games.
According to NJ.com, more than 70 residents showed up to a township planning board meeting to express their concerns over a proposal for the 28-acre Old U.S. Gypsum paper mill property to the rezoned to allow commercial, retail, and office space. In the end, it approved to rezone the land to light commercial industry.
Each morning, the K3B members are assigned a certain job, and they have to be prepared when the show starts.
Charlie, who's senior?
Yeah, I know.
Yes, that is. When you turn on the mic check. Sports, Charlie!
Me! The mic checks are used in order to check the sound levels for the school to hear. If the levels reach red, they are too loud and become disordered. But if they are green, they are too low and the school cannot hear them. If they are orange-yellow, they are the best sound possible.
This is Natalie Cannavale reporting from behind the scenes of K3B. This is raw, unedited footage.
Get it together, people!
Alright, wait, Christina, what's the out cue? This is your video.
It's
just in the leprechaun dancing! Alright, you type it in then.
Natalie Cannavale, day two. From behind the scenes K2B. Crazy in here.
Oh,
Five, four, three, two. Desiree Sequeira, our news director, stated that if one of the jobs is done incorrectly, the whole show is in jeopardy. Natalie was not harmed during the making of this video.
So, Zach, you're here with the sports.
I am here with the sports, and it was some day yesterday in sports. So let's get into it. In basketball, the Nuggets beat the 76ers to extend their 14-game win streak, 101-100.
That's great.
I know. That's great. Also, the Devils beat the Hurricanes 4-1, so that's good for the Devils fans.
Yeah, I'm a Devils fan, so it's great.
Yeah, I'm a Rangers fan, but that's not good. And also, in the March Madness tournament, the number 14 seed Harvard upset the number 3 seed New Mexico, 68-62.
That is fantastic for Harvard, you know,
yes,
number 14 being the 3 seed.
Yeah, not many people saw that one coming.
Jeremy Lin's not even on the team.
Nah, no Linsanity. All
right, so back in the news.
Today's KTV birthday is Reese Witherspoon. Reese Witherspoon is a famous actress and is in many famous films such as Legally Blonde, Wildflower, and The Trumpet of the Swan. According to IMDb.com, her first major film was The Man in the Moon. Witherspoon's full name is really Laura Jeanne Reese Witherspoon.
The universe is a little older and perhaps a bit stranger than previously thought. According to the best measurements ever taken of the radiation left over just after the Big Bang, the universe is about 13.81 billion years old, or 80 million years older than the previously thought. So, Christina.
So, Greg, we have a break in the show.
Yeah, with Desiree and Megan over there.
So, let's pass it over to them.
Tez, you're on camera.
I know, I'm writing my yearbook thing. Don't you want one?
Sure. What is it?
All you have to do is write your name, like, right where it says name, your grade, your homeroom, and your homeroom teacher.
And today's
Sorry you couldn't hear that.
Yeah. You know,
or see it.
Yeah, or see it,
but
let's get back into the news. Music videos are constantly being downloaded, bought, and viewed all the time now. Though, some videos don't exactly make sense along with the song. They are still extremely popular in the entertainment videos. According to Vivo.com, records right now show that Love the Way You Lie by Eminem featuring Rihanna is currently at number 3 for most viewed video of all time with 550 million views. At number 2, On the Floor by Jennifer Lopez featuring Pitbull has 660 million views. Lastly, at number 1, with 850 million views, comes Baby by Justin Bieber. Baby was written by Christopher Stewart, Tarius Nash, and Justin Bieber himself.
Last night were the annual police awards where many officers were awarded for their effort, heroism, detective work, and life-saving skills. The awards ranged from platoon or group awards to critical and life-saving. Each award is based on the way the responding police officer or officers handled the situation and what they did to help the individuals or individuals.
So, Christina, here at the weather.
Yeah, I'm here with the weather. It's really cold out, though, so... Today, it'll be partly cloudy with a high of 43, and then tomorrow, there will be a high of 45, and it'll once again be partly cloudy.
So, it's kind of nice out.
Yeah, it's a little bit, but it could be warmer.
Yeah.
And then on Sunday, it will be mostly cloudy with a high of 46.
That's great.
Yeah, well, it's warmer than usual. And lastly, on Monday, there will be a mix of rain and snow with a high of 41.
Yeah, so it's getting a little colder.
Yeah, and then there's rain and snow.
So, Greg, it's the end of the show.
Yeah.
But we do have a sneak peek of when we get back from spring break.
Yes.
We have a preview of that show, so let's pass it over to Des and Courtney.
Thanks, guys. So, like you guys said, spring break is here, so we'll be coming back on Tuesday. But don't worry, we still have a jam-packed show.
We have an interview with Autism Awareness Month and where it came from, and we also have a video on sportsmanship, and I am so excited, Des, what about you?
Yeah, I'm so excited, break and the show on Tuesday. It's going to be a jam-packed show. Yeah. Back to you guys on the studio.
So I'm definitely excited.
Me too. That's going to be a great show.
Yeah, something to look forward to.
Yeah. For even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Christina and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm Greg. Have a adjacent day.